Appreciate.
Very smooth. We've had minimal issues with like.
Do not jinx it, you punk. I mean, hey. Okay, so game two, we've got the merry duo, Samwise Jenkins and Fried Nuggets. They actually changed their name at the last second because apparently Fried Jenkins wasn't cutting the mustard. And they're up against Warriors of Haldir, Zaid and Witch King. And I'm super excited for this. But Mac, I actually forgot to ask you, who do you think is going to win this tournament? I mean, not who you think is going to win, who you're rooting for is the point.
I don't know. I mean, Zaid's my man. Like, these are two of my mods in my Twitch chat fighting each other. So, I mean, that's a tough one. I'm not going to play any favorites at all.
For the whole tournament, I'm going Sean Power all the way. He's going to surprise us all. Why is chat going crazy?
I don't know.
Oh, shit. Have you turned off Ring Heroes? Okay, good. Someone just gets sour. All right, GG. All right, I see. All right, goodbye. Just leaves. All right, here we go. Let's go.
Where does Ross live? The planet Earth.
Have you heard of a country called Azerbaijan? I haven't.
Have you heard of the country of Wangpu?
What? All right, I'm not playing favorites. Zaid.
I've seen a bit of the Witch King play, and I've seen a bit of Nuggets play. I think the two main contesters are Zaid and Samwise, so we'll see who's better.
I've never seen Samwise Jenkins played, but since he's always so like energetic, so hyped up, I actually can't wait to see him.
Just so you know, someone named Polite Devil just followed.
Have you seen the random armies? Have you seen what they've got?
Oh. Oh. Well, it's up to
Game's
to
going
get
to crash
right here,
now.
So.
Drake's follow win.
FTW. Ming. Let's go, Zaid Jenkins. That's not a thing! Imagine if they were on a team. Just imagine.
Oh, I'll imagine it.
All right,
so we've
got
three goblins and an elf. It pretty much, if he can get Silverthorns, he can just kill everyone. Just run riot.
GLHF. Man, no HF.
Witch King hasn't given away what faction he is. We will expand the caves. And Samwise Jenkins doesn't feel the need to that either. So I think whoever's playing is the elves. Who is it? Nuggets? All right, Nuggets. Don't let me down here, boy.
I think that might be the game changer. What if they...
I'm going to stare at the signal fire, so you can just keep talking now.
Okay. Well, we've got resources. They're getting bigger. They're good. Okay, first to change of rules, the first person to 5,000 resources wins. Go.
They build nothing but walls and then just like one tunnel. Like, come on.
That zoom though, I wish I could zoom out a little more, but it's 1.6 for you. Not too much you can do.
I'm actually used to the zoom.
I was until I played 1.6, and I'm like, I like 1.6 better, but 1.8 zoom. That zoom though.
You can change it, we just never bothered to find out. So yeah, pretty slow start. There's not actually much to commentate on since three of them are goblins. We have a goblin cave up, we have a tunnel up. Jenkins going with a pretty ordinary maneuver. This is why it's always good to scout. Always good to scout. If you don't go for the scouting power, always send a unit in to quickly check out what enemy faction they are. Because if I knew my enemy was goblins, and I was goblins too, it would be a race to get spider riders and then just wreck.
That's
just
what I do.
Freaking wreck.
And it works every time. Unless you're playing Sean Power and he knows that that's what you did last time, then he just makes tower guards and fucks up everything. I'm sorry, flashback.
I just worry, if they're all equally shit, we could be here for 4 hours playing this game.
I don't know, goblins up top are already going in. Who's at the bottom, just so I know? Samwise Jenkins is at the bottom, so he's doing battle.
Nuggets and Jenkins are at the bottom, because they're a team.
Oh, Zay, my two mods going head-to-head. Oh, man.
Is Jenkins a mod too?
I am. Jenkins is a recent, much more recent mod.
Okay. The elves are opening up with Lauren Arches, as you should.
Oh, Sam's already losing his resources.
Oh my goodness, who is...
Zaid's just
Holy shit,
in.
That's Zaid's play! Super aggro, he's taking out the tunnel. Zaid actually told me he hadn't played in 2 weeks. I'm calling bullshit on that. He's got the green goblins, he's got poison blades, he's taking out a tunnel.
Oh, goblins and elves are tangling now.
This is some really cool goblin action going on here. Let's have a look at the first elven encounter. They're just running away, like, no.
Ooh, that tower. That was a good move on Sam's part, getting that tower up nice and early.
You'll see that Noggets is actually moving his archers out of the cave bats, but the cave bats are just following him.
Oh, it's 1k for anyone asking.
Yeah, it's a 1k start.
4K equals. Oh, you're dwarves? Well, I have Gimli now, so you're done.
It's always so good what Zaid's done to have such an aggressive placement on Tainted Land, because that way you can't really retreat out of it. So the enemy's always going to have that armor bonus that Tainted Land gives you.
Alright,
another Elven Archer is coming out. You know how we were saying that the lairs are so important, so vital? Like, killing a lair, you get a lot of money, really boosts your economy early game. Mm-hmm. On this map, there's only two Cave Troll lairs, and Cave Trolls do not go down easy in this one, so that sort of, doesn't give people an unfair advantage for going for the lairs.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. Unless you're maybe mortal, like, two Eastlings can probably do it. But that's still, like, two Eastlings away from your base, but whatever.
Or you can do what I do and send the Swordmen in against the Wargs and get them killed.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. What a knob. Alright, Zaid's doing exactly what I wanted him to do. He's got the spider pet out. If the only counter for that would be half trolls, and well, I think Jenkins is running into a little bit of trouble. He does have Zaid outnumbered here, but he's only got one goblin cave.
If he can get he's not even going for spider riders, he's going for spiderlings. Look at that. Zaid, what you doing, bud? What you doing?
Well, spiderling and then just harass our resources, because they do scurry around it like Sonic the Hedgehog, so that's pretty good.
You're right. Gotta go fast. Well, elves and I feel like this side, like the side on the left, is always kind of at a standpoint. The other two's, like the other side on the right, is just always going at it. Always.
Well, that's been the trend so far.
I think the trend's gonna break, though. Oh, Haldir's here!
Bullshit! Is he really? Yeah. The second he was made, you knew that. How? You got like some Craig Parker Sixth Sense going on? Like, what the hell?
I happened to be at the fortress. It was calling me. It was calling me. I'm Haldir.
Damn it, Nuggets. I'm Haldir. I've lost Lord. Oh, I always remember Eowyn. I fear neither death nor pain. What do you fear? Craig Parker. Oh, man.
Same.
This is Jenkins going on a pretty good offensive. He's only had about three battalions of Goblin Warriors, but they're standing firm. They are standing firm, but I think the Spiderlings, with the aid of the Goblin Archers, are going to push back. Another Goblin Archer coming in. Come on, Zaid, get some Spider Riders. You can wreck everything. If you look at the Witch King, he's built a fissure. I don't know if he's going to try and get some Cave Trolls or maybe Half Trolls. Haldir is going in with some Archers. Here we go. If he can level up fast enough, he'll get a nice little leadership. What level does he get leadership?
Oh,
level
rest 4? In peace.
There you go. Exactly. Like Nugget should have pretty much. Yep.
Oh, but he's got his he's got his pikemen out, so he might be all right.
Witch King actually retreated his spider riders. I didn't get that. He could have got three battalions worth of kills just then. Oh, but now the Mythlon's coming. I will kill him. Witch King has seen the Haldir and he's just incensed by that.
Zaid's little spiderling army is going at her.
Witch King, what are you doing? Get your spider riders to hit the archers. Why don't go for Craig
Parker? Going the wrong way. Uh-oh. I might be
I hit the wrong button. Haldir is just going to level up for fucking days now. Poison blades will take their toll, but the glory of Spider Riders. Did you see that trample? Hold on, we got Zaid moving in now. Spiderlings. Does he know that Spiderlings can't trample? You should use them for destroying resources. That's what they're good for.
Zaid's coming in for the save.
Mike Puller, how fucking happy are you that Haldir's made it in game 2 of his own tournament? It's just fucking great.
I'm less happy that he's poisoned right now.
Yeah, but he's reached level 4. He's got his leadership. He's bugging the fuck out. That's an extra damage on Lorien archers.
No, I use him so little. Like, I didn't even realize he had leadership. That's actually kind of useful.
Yeah, yeah. The one after that, the light arrow, the whatever the fuck it's called. Yeah, just pretend it's not there. You don't see anything. Oh man. Lorien warriors are like 400, and he's just sending them to their death against half trolls, which is kind of strange. They're gonna get banner carriers for this. So Jenkins did well to survive the early assault. It seems that tower in his base really did work. It seems that the teammates are building barracks in their teammates' base pretty early on. That's, I guess that's...
I don't know if that's a sign of confidence or just a sign of, like...
If you get owned, if you get wrecked, I'm not saying you will, but if, this will be here. Oh, shit. Is it me, or in the 360 version did the Half-Troll Marauders look super cool? Unless they look like they're wearing, like... dildo hats.
Well, I mean, they're not wearing dildo hats.
Like, it's really weird.
Thanks for the follow, the Zach Cum.
You know the day will come when this game gets an HD remake? And, there's actually an HD mod coming out for this game. It's in development right now, and they've worked on a couple factions.
Oh, really?
And I should actually be able to test it out soon, and it does look really cool.
oh, Zaid's going in with the spiders. Actually, Zaid's just like, hello. I'm just going to sneak on in here.
Yep, that's exactly what they're used for, the spylings. They're trying to trip him. But you should use them in coordination with the rest of your army. So now he should send in cave trolls to attack the fortress.
So that's just if he sends them in and then have them chase, you could send your entire army on the left side and be like, I'm just going to skip everything.
I do wonder why he hasn't built spider riders yet. I think I've crushed him too many times with spider riders that he just hates them now. He just can't stand them.
Just can't do it. Man.
All right, so Nagus has taken the cave troll lair. He's got a nice, what, like 600 gold from that. He's also got two elven towers on the hill. That essentially neuters, unless they're dwarven guardians charging from that essentially neuters any attack without siege.
The Junker asks, how do you know what a dildo hat looks like?
It's called hyperbole! I certainly don't own one and keep it in my desk drawer! No! Clench his butthole.
Whenever you talk about your dildo hat, I clench my butt.
That's a weird reaction. One of these days, Mac.
Imagine an HD 3D remake of this game. It'd be so underwhelming.
Yeah, imagine a VR remake of this.
Virtual reality Battle for Middle-earth.
Two tainted lands used around the base. Zaid, if you can hear me, send your half-trolls into the fortress. They can kill it in about 5 seconds. Why are they... What are they doing? Not playing favorites.
He's got a tower right in the middle.
The Witch King is doing what I like to do in protecting my tunnels with towers. And, I don't know. I think with leadership, these Mythlons should actually be able to deal with it pretty damn easy. The rest of the Golden Army is just sitting tight. Jenkins is probably screaming for help. I don't know if they're in a... Yep, Lauren Archers are here. If you can get an Elven Tower in your base, in Samwise's base, that should keep him at bay for a little bit.
For a second when you told me that, I thought you were asking me to do it, and I thought we were in a game for a second, and I almost...
And you like, oh my goodness, like, my heart just stopped. Like, no! Haldir's gonna just first build a kill of the game, and it's gonna be Haldir that does it!
Thanks for the purest donation, Rivenol. I can't really read the message here, so I'm just gonna listen for it. But thanks a ton, man.
Is it Callous Whisper by George Michael?
Oh, he says he donated $10 and says, go PINKYAM.
Oh, wow. Should the donation go to them? What?
I guess so. If you guys win, you get this $10.
All proceeds go to that sexy fuck you're looking at right now.
I think it'd be really cool to do some sort of charity tournament at some point. Like, just so that it's not, you know, let's go into something.
Yeah, that would be actually pretty good. Like a 24-hour, just non-stop game range of BFME2 and just donate for a good cause.
Yeah.
Maybe we should do that. Samwise Jenkins is on the move. He's got a cave troll. If he's clever, he'll use the Golden Warriors to tank the fortress. But finally, Zaid has made spider riders, so goodbye to most of those. Nope, Zaid fucked it up.
He's got his marauders in a perfect spot, though.
Yeah.
Witch
King is actually coming into his teammate's aid, and goodbye, Goblin Archers. Look at that trample. Did you see any slowdown on that trample? I sure as hell didn't. That is why they're awesome.
Nope.
And why they don't actually get heavy armor, which is perfectly fine. Are the elves going the offensive?
No, Witch King's just holding it down for the underground right now, and Sam is just pushing up. But he kind of got shit on now that he's got his all his other units out. His marauders, though, he had them placed pretty well, like right in the middle. It's like, yeah, you want to trample something? Well, you're going to get dead if you do. I'd like to see some tournament in a Dane mod. That might be...
Yeah, we were actually thinking about that earlier today. We would say, you know what, let's make the next tournament in a Dane. Because it is like the huge thing now with BFME2, so... Ooh,
we've got elves coming in for a sneak attack. Check it out.
Do we? Round the back?
Yep, round the back.
Oh, you said sneak attack. That's fucking Haldir. God, alert me when something of merit actually happens.
But
I think Goblins is actually pushing in now. That first battle tower is slightly wounded. Nuggets is turtling a lot. If he can get Elrond out here, or maybe Legolas, then, he could actually do a lot of good.
Sam's rebuilding, Zaid's rebuilding. I think Zaid's going over to help, Zaid's going over to help his friend, like the Witch King, so if Sam attacks now, I think
Haldir could die, because there's a lot of Spider Riders heading that way, and I don't think he has the strength to repel him. Plus, Oh, man. See, Lauren Warriors are so good at taking out resources, they actually have really good attack, but... Because of the present threat of Spider Riders, he has to build Mythlons, and now they're just being wrecked from range. God damn it. That is why Spider Riders are just awesome. Oh man. Where is Haldir? I've sort of lost him and all that.
You've lost Haldir? Oh, there he is. It's like Where's Waldo, but way better.
Yeah, but way more interesting.
And pretty easy, because you can see his giant forehead for miles.
Okay, so apparently Haldir did manage to make it out. I don't know how. There's a blue army at the back. Whose is that? Oh, that's Samwise. Okay.
coming in for the defense.
You know, I did predict that this would be like a 3-hour game, so I'm not saying
down, kids.
I'm not send in my mightiest forces. The laborers damaging.
He's
building a lumber mill. Yep, he's prepping for the greatest army of all. What is this unit here? Just archers, okay.
Where's the Haldir? Haldir's here. He's over here.
He's by the cave troll, yep.
Hey, there he goes, Haldir.
I think he's probably gonna take out the other lair just to level up Haldir a little bit more. I don't know. Not really sure what Jenkins is doing.
I'm not sure either. Like, he's...
There's a lot of, this is actually quite a quiet period. Everyone's not really sure. No one's really been able to make a breakthrough, so... If I were any of them, although I know things that they don't because I can see the entire map, I would start getting my upgrades out.
Yeah, this is where it really helps if you're in a Skype call with your teammate.
Although, saying that, Fried Nuggets has a level 3 Origian Forge, so he's probably way ahead of me anyway. He's about to get Silver Thorns.
Ooh.
Elves are going in for a massive push. He should be coordinating his assaults with Jenkins because he doesn't want to be flanked by an army of Spider Riders.
I'm keeping my eyes on that, that right there.
Rallying calls come in, but the archers are ahead of the phalanx.
Got Haldir coming on in for a butt kicking.
And the Silver Thorns are out. He needs to get the pikes in front of the archers immediately. They got his porcupines behind them. Holy shit, look at the damage these half trolls do to the mighty Craig Parker.
Christ. Craig Parker, you need to go back to Spartacus, buddy.
Imagine Craig Parker at 300. Our arrows will block out the sun. Where's Galadriel? God damn it, God.
Our arrows will blot out the sun, then we'll shoot them in the dark. Did I make it funny?
Yeah. I'm taking on a biscuit, though.
That's something I didn't do today. Eat. Probably do
damn
that.
It, Mac. You had one job.
I mean, we've got two more battles before the semifinals, right?
Yeah, we can have intermission after game 4, so you can eat them. We'll have like a 10-minute intermission.
Cool. Gives me a chance to get rid of the bottom part of that over there.
God damn it.
Ah, look at those silver thorn arrows. Just beautiful to look at. Just a beautiful bundle of blue flying at your face.
He's invested money in them. He's upgraded them. And now they're just gonna die.
But he's sending his Lorians over to Sam's?
Jenkins hasn't done much here for a while. And I am really thinking he's making a labor army. I seriously think that's what he's amassing.
Maybe he's gonna go for some Drake.
Or a Drake. Has he upgraded the fortress? Let's have a look.
Why isn't there a mod where when you buy a Drake, like Drake the rapper comes out and he's just like, I don't know, and
because he's Canadian and no one likes him. Oh, you walked into that. I've just realized that none of these goblin players have gone for, what is it? Cave bats. So none of them really know when the enemy's attacking because they didn't go for that expanded vision, and I don't know why.
You got a solid defense here, though. Like, the elves, they're holding...
It's going to be a 3-hour game. Fuck this noise. I'm taking off the tie. You weren't wearing a tie. I'm taking it off!
Okay, imagine I had a tie. Yeah. Okay, you see the tie? Yeah. Well, I'm taking it off.
Yeah. Shia LaBeouf, that bitch. Look at Jenkins' army. Just imagine a freaking arrow volley going in there. That'd be amazing.
Apparently you're on fire today, says Haldir's Hungry Hippos. I see his name, and I'm just like, ooh. Callum Jones, well, you're not too late. You only missed one match, man. I get a chance to read the chat while nothing is happening, so this is good.
Our arrows will blot out the sun, then we'll shoot them in the dark. Damn it, Mac.
Potato Man says, Mac, you should make some mac and cheese. Never heard that one before! Oh, man. 98 viewers. Holy shist. What?
98? Why? There is rugby on today.
Can we make that 100? That would be sweet.
Yeah, two Smurf accounts. 100. Fine.
Mac 1, Mac 2.
Samwise Jenkins writes, get ready, goblins! Which can just write, bravo.
I slept 13 hours for this, says the tiger.
You know you didn't have to do that, right? I just hope Sean Powell is up in time, because he was partying all last night and only had about 6 hours sleep, so he's going to be playing with a hangover.
Oh, we've got elves moving on in for the kill.
See, look at the glowy yellow stuff under their feet. That's the leadership of Craig Parker there, gentlemen.
Ooh.
That's what it does for you. Ross, look at my base. I'm expanding the cave. You're supposed to win, not trying to... He's expanding the cave. Holy fucking shit.
We hit 100, Ross Devil.
That was really quick on the Smurf accounts. Very good job, guys. Don't send in Craig Parker against those. Holy shit, he didn't. He actually backed him up at the very last second.
105, we're doing
that. Samwise Jenkins should really be covering his back. These are a lot of units that he's just clashing in. Oh, Outer of Volley comes in.
Shit.
That is a huge, actually not such a big hole. He missed quite a lot of it. Two KO trolls are just battering them from the rear. On his last assault, he did use up freaking heal, so I don't think he has it again.
You said battering from the rear, and I'm an adult, so I didn't laugh at it.
Zaid's moving his army. In fact, if I were him, I'd move it into the Elven base.
That's a good idea. Oh, except Sam just came out of a tunnel. Look at that. He's got like a small task force there. That is not going to work. If anything, I'd just go for... I just make it look like he's going for him and then attack from this side.
It's fun being able to see the entire map. Please tell me what's going on in my game, Mac. I can't do that. Fuck you.
How are the elves?
All of that entire elven army is being debuffed and they are slowly but surely dying. You know why, Mac? Because half trolls don't die. And it's because of the dildo hats.
Yeah, GF, I'll have to turn off my Skype notification sounds after this match.
Just be thankful no one's called you, because that would just full tab you out of the game. Zaid launches in Spider Riders to attack a building, and they're set to fucking range. God damn it. Oh, but look at Scavenger. That is just an amazing ability when you've got a trample. Oh my god.
Elves are
look how many units
save.
Are outside Ooh. The Elven base. If he makes a Gatewatchers expansion, is that Gatewatchers? No, just a regular tower.
I don't know who's who. I think it's... Oh, they're sending in the trolls. Trolls!
God damn it. That is why Jenkins said get ready, goblins. It's because he's made Gore kill the Goblin King, but Zaid is just retaliating. Holy crap.
I don't know if Zaid's gonna get any trolls in.
No, the Silver Thorns came out. Oh, those
he's got
things.
One attack at half
he's gonna die.
Marauders.
He's gonna die. Oh, he's actually at the fortress. He's made it. One cave troll's made it. Are they encasing vines on that? No,
yeah,
they're not.
No, they've got the armor. No eagles nest there, though. I think that would be a game changer because none of the goblins have archers because their archers suck.
Spider Riders?
Spider Riders, but they kind of suck as archers, let's be real. Hmm. They're only good for running shit over, and you can't run over eagles unless
this is
gonna
be
wings.
This is one huge turtle fest. That huge offensive that took Zaid about 50 hours just died in a matter of seconds. Oh, man.
Germans and a huge Marcus. Is that German for penis? Because... Oh.
Yes, Marcus is German for penis. Mac, what the fuck are you talking about?
Dash market. How do you say gigantic? Oh, das market transgross.
I know that the German word for fat is actually dick, so... I'm not even joking, it is, look it up.
You fat?
Yeah. Yeah. Damn it, Paula. Why are we wearing these suits? I'm fucking boiling in here.
Because it's esports! Well, it's Canada. I live in Canada. Oh, Gorkil's dead. Done, bud. You're done. Hey, guys, where can I find a tournament website? We don't actually really have a tournament website. But if you follow...
Did someone think we had a tournament website? We must be doing something right now.
I mean, I guess we're doing all right. I wonder what Tolkien
actually,
would think about this. I think Tolkien would be proud. Actually, I think he'd be like, what is this? I wrote this and now these people are making poop jokes and...
Well, no, he was... First and foremost, he was the biggest geek, so I'm pretty sure he'd just be amazed that his creation is in a freaking computer.
I think he'd be amazed at what a computer is, because that's kind of...
Well, yeah.
Kind of died
exactly.
Those were a thing.
He's like, you know Samwise? Yeah. Well, when he dies, he goes, "Arr!" in this game. Isn't that amazing? Get out. Uh-oh.
How do you say gigantic? Max D. Oh, thank you, I think.
Samwise Jenkins made a mountain giant when no one was looking, and now he's within range of the buildings.
Shit.
Huge army that he had for the longest time is done a lot of work, but now they're pretty much running on empty at this point.
Let's take a moment to actually appreciate the real backbone of Sam's army, though. The laborers.
They are. Backbone of the economy. Small business right there. Less than 50 employees. That counts.
Everyone has a job and they all do it to make sure that the company grows.
And this is our plant, Timmy.
This is we're chopping up the plant, Timmy.
Haldir versus Gorkil. Nope, they're actually on the same team. Never mind, I didn't say shit.
You ever notice that the tree that they're sawing in the lumber mills, it just kind of grows back?
Yeah,
like a retractable
really,
penis.
It's really weird.
But they're
Have you noticed that when this thing kicks a fortress, it dies a little inside?
The fortress? Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It dies a lot inside.
I think Zaid might be in. I don't know.
Well, the second mountain giant came in. I think Witch King is probably swearing at Zaid in every language he knows. But will the half trolls make it? I don't think so. Zaid can actually endure. You should never give up in these games. Always try and get a builder out to your teammate's base and get a goblin cave or something. But oh my goodness, Jenkins, who really didn't, can't stop the Haldir. You know what? He speaks the truth. So many, like, this could have really dragged on, but this one big push that Jenkins did with quite a mediocre army, really. A lot of it was just made up of the weakest units, but the Mountain Giants really told. Like, the siege, this, like, such versatile siege like the Mountain Giants. What
Witch
the hell?
Oh,
Haldir's gonna die!
Witch
no!
King's on the defense, though. I think he just bailed out.
He is. No, he sent a lot of units to kill Haldir, so Witch King, I know Witch King's like, he's dead.
Well, it's definitely not over until it's over, and he's sending in all his trolls. Oh, no, he's retreating the trolls.
You know what's funny is, Zaid and Witch King's team name is Warriors of Haldir, and then they just killed Haldir, so...
Tachunka asks, yeah. Will this be the greatest comeback of BFME history? I don't know, we'll have to see, because Zaid's... Oh.
The greatest comeback of BFME history is uploaded on fucking Zaid's channel. I was in the driver's seat, Matt Pollitt says he doesn't have a builder, and then just shows up with like 18 fucking trebuchets led by Aragorn, so... Yeah, good times.
Best.
Even if that spider pit goes down from these wildmen, which is all likely, I think Zaid still has a building in his base. He still has a goblin cave.
He does, and then he's got one in Witch King's base.
See, that is the joy of 2v2 gameplay. Oh, the ants are coming. Yep, that's pretty much game. Nothing can stop an ant. Or is that tree bird?
Let's get fire arrows, and it doesn't look like they have anything really good for the cavalry.
Yeah. Ants are actually super strong in that game, but it is counteracted by the fact that, I mean, fire arrows just wrecks them, so...
Oh, Zaid's
all right, Witch King is going to try and avenge Zaid's base. He's got four or five half-trolls backed up by two cave trolls entering the arena now.
And Zaid's getting another fortress up, man. This could be a good pushback on Witch King's part.
What the hell, Zaid? Where did he get the money for another fortress? Where is it?
He lives in Dubai. He's probably rich as fuck. Oh, look at this push!
Jenkins, that was an awesome push, but watch how quickly these half-trolls take down this fortress, if they're positioned correctly. You know what I'm talking about. Actually, Arrow Volley coming might actually do a number on that.
Ooh.
Shit. No, reinforcements coming right on cue.
I think they've got it, man. This could be a comeback here.
Yep, but remember, Jenkins has got a building in his teammate's base, too. I don't think these Mythlons are really gonna do much, do you? Yeah, me neither. Oh, man. Cave Trolls should finish up. Yeah. Man, half trolls are super tanky. I don't know many units that can resist. Well, like main pike units that can resist an arrow volley. Maybe tower guards as well.
Everything's been even. Oh, Sam just got his gore kill back out just in time.
A rebuild comes out of nowhere. What the fuck?
Why?
So I don't know how that fortress didn't go down.
That is insane. Wow.
How is that still alive?
I have no clue.
Mythlons were defending that. You know what? I think that's a bit on Witch King's fault. He should have positioned his half-trolls a little better. I think people get carried away. They're like, oh my goodness, fortress is about to go down.
Oh, and then he might finish it off. He might finish it off.
What's coming in now?
He's going in for the kill. He's got Wildman in. He's going in.
Go on, Wildman. Why am I rooting? I should be neutral. Fuck that.
Oh, man.
I'm watching that fortress health bar intensely. It's not really going down.
Watcher in the water. Who's Watcher is it, though? It's the Witch King. That might finish it.
That should hit nearby buildings. I don't know if it's close enough. It's actually killing a lot of his wild men. Fuck you, Sam, he says.
Oh, man, that is
I love the freaking emotion people put into this. How these... There it goes. What a game. What
down
a game.
She goes. It's not over yet, though. We've still got Zaid rebuilding. We've got... Man, like, I don't even know what to think. Like, you see it, and you think it's over, and then, no, someone just comes back.
Why isn't this game in first person? I want to be a half-troll. Like, there should be BFME2 Battlefront, where it's just first person, and you get to fight shit like that. That'd be amazing.
They do have it. It's called Conquest, and it sucked a lot of penis.
Oh, that sucked, dick. You shut your damn mouth. I hated that game.
I'm just saying, they tried. They tried.
They tried.
To Chunko, that gave me a hard-on.
Oh, there's an eagle out. Okay, that should actually bring some balance, though.
Balance to the farce.
Remember in 1.8 when they made the eagles white because racist? Yeah.
I remember. That eagle's
he picked up a spider. Holy shit, that's one intense fucking eagle.
Along came a spider and sat down beside him. And Haldir.
Mac, if I was to make you a mod... If I was to make a mod for you, I'm pretty sure I would make the eagles owls, and then you could just have an owl.
Can someone make a mod for me? Just like, I basically just build... The objective is you gotta build walls around, like, Aeon. And Aowen is actually called Mac Pollitt.
Actually, I haven't told Chad about this yet, but Witch King has made a mod for me called the Haldir MLG mod, and I will be testing it out after this tournament, so you have that to look forward to.
Ooh. Oh, yeah. Oh, another fortress being built.
This has been so strange. First they destroy Zaid's fortress, and then a huge counterattack out of nowhere from Witch King destroyed Sam's fortress, and I think they're both rebuilding it.
Everyone's talking about
getting their fortresses back. See, this is what I mean. People have the spare cash for an extra fortress. That's why I only wanted maximum one. Because otherwise, it's just, yeah.
Yeah, then it just gets, it just lasts forever.
Heavy armor's coming in the Mithril Sentry. Spider Rider's effectiveness is essentially reduced to nothing since they can't tramp. They can't insta-kill heavy units now.
I thought it was over twice now, and I'm impressed that they keep coming back.
Well, if you look at your mini-map, there's a huge blue blob heading in.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the Mighty Jenkins. So, they've left the elves, they've left the elves, they've left the elves. Now they're fully upgraded with their heavy armor.
And
booyah.
The eagles are coming! The eagles! Oh, Ents. Ents, eagles. It's over.
Alright, now just watch. We will swarm over you! You know, you're partnering with the elves, right? Alright, now just watch the damage these Ents do. If he hits the fortress, just wait. If when they throw their rocks, they do an absurd amount of damage.
There's a lot of buildings around here.
Look, they're taking out Zaid's fortress. They want him to get out. I think he's only got a couple more buildings left. Holy shit, I can't believe we all went random and there were three goblins. Like, random? I don't think you were.
Good job, BK.
I love how we missed all these units. You can just see Haldir from a freaking mile away because of this goddamn red cave. It's awesome.
Dude, those archers just weren't doing anything for a sec. Now they're kicking some ass. Look at that blue beam of happiness.
Blue beam of happiness. You mean the yellow swag Skrillex beam of happiness?
Yeah.
There's a level 5 Lorien Archer on aggressive mode there. I think Nuggets knows his stuff.
I see Gil Salad in
Remember?
The chat.
Gil Salad. Come on, chat. Gil Salad. Nope, my fuck you guys.
Oh, there goes the fortress. A long game
oh,
ends and
gone.
Sat down beside her and now she's dead.
Now her name's Sally Mustang. Curse you and the rude devil who forced you in this tournament. Sorry! Oh, man.
I think this is game.
I kind of wanted Fried Nuggets to win from the beginning because he made Haldir, and it seems that Haldir is going to deliver the coup de grace on the freaking fortress.
That's it. That's the one. Curses! Look at those archers.
And Samwise Jenkins is speaking in Who's Duel, so there you go.
Eagle! Man, that eagle just looks like it won everything for him.
There you go. Yep.
I mean,
holy shit, that builder just imploded like a neutron star. Holy god.
I think unless someone has a very impressive, like, demolisher crew or something like it on standby, I think this is GG.
You know, dwarves on it. Oh, could you imagine if you could recruit the dwarves, like, just add an outpost and you get demolishers? That'd be sweet. Oh, that poor cave troll tripped as he left the cave troll.
Just like, I just wanted to slap a Haldir.
Now, knowing Zaid, he's just gonna have one builder running around building little barracks after barracks after barracks. In fact, I'm going to try and look for... Yep, there it is.
Oh,
right
boy.
There.
Oh, boy.
That's Witch King. I don't know where Zaid's building his. Oh, Zaid's been defeated. He didn't get a chance. That's strange for him, though.
Damn.
Witch King says he's never going to give up. Never. That's the fighting spirit there, lad. You should never, ever surrender. Keep fighting.
Damn, Haldir. Back at it again with the shiny bow.
Fall into the nothingness that awaits you.
Damn you, Craig Parker.
That's like one of my favorite lines from Return of the King. Gandalf just like, send these foul creatures into the abyss, and then he just launch all those trebuchets. It's so cool.
Potato Man with the best pun. He says, whoa, pretty entertaining. You shut your damn mouth. How is this not over? Like, didn't they?
There's a goblin cave.
But where? Just give up, damn it!
Poor Zaid, knocked out of the first round of again. It's like me cheering him on is actually a negative consequence. God damn it.
It's actually killing him deep inside. But where is it? I think they should just
halfway between Witch King and Zaid's base. There's a goblin cave right at the top of the map.
Right at the top. All the way to the top.
You will pay for this. I don't think so. You've got two goblins named Frank and Sally just dancing around, and there's an eagle on the way. And they found it. There you go.
GG. Oh,
if you
want
to hide your barracks, you hide it in plain sight. That's why you hide it next to the city.
It's too bad us as observers can't just, like, call in, you know, like, the fires of doom just to, like, crush stuff.
That would be amazing. Just, like, super host support, like enable god mode.
We're like Call of Duty, like Call of Duty kill streaks. It's like, oh, 25 kills, tactical nuke.
Yeah, tactical
nuke. You win.
I remember the day I got a tactical nuke. It's the only time I've ever got a tactical nuke in Call of Duty, and I was super happy.
I had it once, and it was a good day.
My dick were so tiny that day. And that should be game. Round two goes to the merry duo. Holy shit. Fried Nuggets and Samwise Jenkins are in the semi-final. They'll be facing PINKYAM. Oh my god, this is going to be amazing. Anyway, thanks for watching. Game two.